So, coming next to the conceptual image of your structure, you have a, what do you mean by conceptual? Conceptual means concepts. So once this is again an outcome, one was the perception, other is the concept of that order and space. Now you have organized things into different, you have organized the space, the structure and the enclosure into a particular form, and you now you want that also to have a particular concept, which I told you last time that there are systems of different orders. I showed you an example of the Greek order, wherein there were columns of different levels, short right from the small, shortest level kit, then to the topmost orders. So what was the concept behind that? It was, first of all, the concept was, what is the height that you want to achieve? What is the height that you want to achieve inside? And then when you look from the outside, how, now if you have, this is a, it's also known as the Thomsø building. If you are looking at this building, you'll realize when you move away from the building that the building is changing its shape. When you are moving closer, it becomes blue. Then when you move back the steps, it changes color to orange color. So the building itself in same lighting conditions, it's changing the color. It's actually the perception, which I wanted to tell you, that there is the comprehension, there is a perception, but what is, how you have placed it, that matters, and that tells you the, that gives you an image and the pattern of that building. First, during the day, you are getting an image and a pattern of that building. Even in, during the night, you are, it's the perception is changing. So the concept is actually such that looking at the same building from different levels, you are getting different colors, you are getting different forms. For example, पहले आपको नजदीक से ये बिल्डिंग इट लुक्स लाइक क्यूबिकल शेप्ड, व्हेन यू मूव अवे इट लुक्स लाइक इट्स अ सर्कुलर बिल्डिंग, एंड व्हेन यू आर फार अवे फ्रॉम द बिल्डिंग इट लुक्स लाइक देर इज ओनली अ डोम विजिबल फ्रॉम द फार अवे ऑफ दिस बिल्डिंग, एंड इट लुक्स लाइक देर इज अ स्ट्रक्चर विद अ डोम इन बिटवीन. Only that part has been made visible. All other parts from far away have been kept hidden. So that's the concept. It's not the concept only of organizing. आप डोम को इसके ऊपर खड़ा करते हो. It's also आप कहाँ से उस बिल्डिंग की ओर देखते हो. तो इसमें एक आर्ट लगता है. तो आर्किटेक्चर एक आर्ट है. ये अचीव करना, दिस इज नॉट ऑफ अरेंजिंग द डिफरेंट बिल्डिंग्स. And there now a sign of which I told you of buildings in the Greek mythology, you had particular signs in the Egyptian, you always found a line shaped structure on a sculpture in front. So in even in today's buildings, you could have the signs over a building. You could have, for example, a circular plate at the top. So there are signs of that building. You want to arrange the building within as a, that's resembling the Thomsø building, though. This is actually resembling the Thomsø building. And then if you have a look, again there is another dome, again resembling the Thomsø building, which is inside located. So Thomson building is the iconic structure of IIT Roorkee. So every university, I'm just diverting a little, should have an iconic structure. This is an iconic structure. You don't make universities in जहां पर सारे बिल्डिंग्स एक जैसे लगे. यू डोंट मेक अ सिटी एंड और एन अर्बन एरिया जहां पर सारे बिल्डिंग्स एक जैसे लगे. देर आर सर्टन स्ट्रक्चर्स जो कि आइकॉनिक होते हैं. अगर पेरिस में आइफल टॉवर है, अगर लंदन में बिग बेन है, यू हैव a building. This is the concept or the context in which you are placing the building. So you have a space in the building, and that space would have a particular form, and that form has got a particular function, and there are certain techniques. This is the spelling here in short form. Techniques it's actually the technology in which they are, through which they are arranged. So this is the summing up of an architectural system. It has got a space, a form, a function, and a particular technology. So this actually is the context in which the building is placed. So any questions up till this point from any one of you? Yes. So here you are seeing three different pictures here visible. First one, you have this is the spatial distribution that you are. So it's also known as the spatial system. So the first one is the spatial. This is the spatial system. And these two are the structural systems. Now, coming first to the structural system, you either have it as a load-bearing structure here, or you have it placed on the columns. Now, in a column structure, as you studied in the design of concrete structures course, you have the floor slab, then a column over it, iske upar baith jayega, there will be another slab, aur uske upar aur columns honge, and then there will be another slab. So this structural system is actually defined. You cannot change. You can just change the column positions. You can, if it's fixed in plan width, plan area. So you can do there is you can change the columns spaces, and you can form different spaces within that column system. If you have a load bearing structure, again there, the walls would determine how the spaces are then organized. So walls become the preliminary barriers there, how you are actually distributing the load. Now, similarly, that also becomes a barrier when walls ke beech mein bahut zyada distance hai, then aap un walls ko, so you cannot place the two walls in a load bearing system at large distance. So spaces are restricted then in that system. A spatial system is apart from these structural systems. You are organizing a space first. You're not determining whether it's a load bearing structure or it's a column structure. As an architect, you are fixing this space. Yahan par kaun kaam pehle kar raha hai? It's almost a structural engineer who is an engineer who is actually designing this framework. And he is, so in a structural system, the dictation is from the structural engineer. The structural engineer is dictating. In a spatial system, it's the architect who is dictating first how the shape of the building has to be, what is the organization of the spaces, so how are the spaces placed one above the other, and then how are those spaces actually being filled up in that void. So this is being dictated by an architectural. So in both these systems, you require a structural engineer in both these systems, finally or initially. But it is who dictates first that is important. And then the second thing is, in a structural system, there is hardly any form or space in which you can play with. You have a particular form, columns ki arrangement ek particular formation mein hoti hai. You can play with just the columns and their placement, and the form cannot be dictated completely. In a special system, you can play with the form of the structural system or the architectural system. There you can dictate how the structure should actually look like. So these two are very important. Which one are you constructing? And who is actually taking up this first? Is it the architect or is it? So the special system has a three-dimensional integration of all the elements now. So let me write it down. So a special system has an integration of primary elements. Now those primary elements, kya hai? Now I'll go to them briefly. So special system has got an integration, rather in detail we'll go into the primary elements. So you are getting, you have the elements which are primary, and then you are getting the space in that system, and the space that you are getting, that will have functions which may be single function or it may be multifunction, and then you have a relationship within the house, between within the structure or the system, within the structure or within the special system. So this is a brief definition of what a special system is. What is a structural system? The structural system is, you're just actually playing with the columns. It's a grid of columns which are arranged in a particular formation. They will have beams connecting them and slabs. They are organized in a particular formation with beams and columns. And there might be certain cantilevers, which can be used for the balcony. So, not that you take the structure to the other floor and go up. So, from the structural system, you are getting the third one, which is from both special systems and structural systems, you get an enclosure system. What is enclosure system? You have walls. So this is actually a pattern of both structural and special system. You have a load-bearing structure, which is more like an enclosure system. So you can at times call it a structural system as well, because it is load-bearing is also a structural system. But just to keep it separate, we can also call it as an enclosure system, where the walls are separating the spaces. And the elements here are the walls, and then there are spaces here within the system. So there are three systems, broadly two, special and structural. And an enclosure system can also be diverted away from the structural system. Yahan se nikal ke aap isko keh sakte ho. This is also a particular form of system. So you have now a form, space, and order of a particular. What do you have? You have, one is a form, then you have a space, and there is an order of a structural system. I'll be showing you some more figures. There could be even more systems, but they are not of the and the structural system itself, but it has got circulation as well. circulation. For example, you have ramps here in the system. There is a ramp here. There's a ramp here going up. So here is the ramp or the stair going up. So you have a circulation also within the system from one floor to another. This is known as circulation. Circulation is how do you move actually from one floor to another. So in every system, you also have a circulation system, whether it be structural system or whether it be special system, you also have sub order uska circulation bhi hai. So the order, the top order is special and structural systems, then structural, you can also take the enclosure system within the top order, then the circulation system is a part of these systems. This is a suborder of these. You require spaces through which you are moving from one story to other. You require spaces through which, for example, in the hospital, now Allah bachaye jo hospital gaya hai, for example, in SKIMS hospital, you must have realized there are ramps on the behind back side of that hospital going towards the top, and at the same time there are different wards and different buildings. They are connected with spaces, small narrow gully like spaces through which you move from one a ward or from one and emergency to ward area, or from ward area to then going into the OPD area. So there are different small gullies through which that aids as circulation spaces. Or so that's, this is a circulation system. It also becomes very vital in big structures like those hospital buildings, where you want, similarly, circulation system becomes important when you want to achieve the fire exits, when you want to have earthquake exits at different levels. So you have to provide the emergency exits. So they also become the part of the circulation system in every building. Just another figure. This will give you an idea of the circulation system. This is this, there could be a lift, lifts. There could be ramps going up. There could be staircases at the same time, rather than ramps, aiding your circulation systems. And then if you reach a particular level, there is a circulation of going into different areas. So you need to provide spaces for going into different areas or with into the different spaces. So what are the elements? I'll describe this briefly in this class. What are the different elements that you have? So now I told you there are different there are elements of a structural system. One is a line. Second one is a plane. Third one is a space. And even before line, the zeroth one could be a point. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
So you have a point, first of all, as a primary element. Point is the first primary element in the structural system. This is a point. I'm just magnifying the point. And from point, अगर आप इसको extend करोगे in a particular direction, a point को, you always get a line. If you extend the point or you join the two points, you get a line. And you have already studied this in drawing. And when you extend the line over a surface, जब आप इसको further extend करते हो इस line को, इसको आप खींचोगे over a surface, you get a plane. This is a plane. It's a plane area. जब आप इस plane को और extend करोगे, इसको और खींचोगे, in that dimension, which I cannot show you here in this, like this, if I, let me draw it, you are extending it in that dimension. So then you are getting a space. So what are the primary elements of a structural system? They are a point, line, plane and space. And they are the elements of a structural or an architectural system both. You can call it as an architectural system on the perspective of if you're an architect or a structural engineer, usko structural system kahega. But when you are studying architecture, you will call it as it is an architectural system. So ab inka maksad kya hai? Point ka, line ka, plane ka, and then of the space. What is the purpose of these? That is very important. Now, first, coming to the point, let me show you certain figures before we move ahead.